Alrighty, what's going on, guys? Mr. JLP here. I'm doing something I've never done before, and I'm ranking slash tier listing all of the Pixar movies. So I want to do a few more of these just because I always go by the rule, try to make content that you yourself enjoy. And I don't know, I think a lot of these are pretty fun, and I have a pretty strong opinion. Quite a few of the Pixar movies. New Horizon, I think it's called. Or no, Onward. Onward. Onward is not on this because that comes out in 2020. But I have seen all of the Pixar movies up to Toy Story 4. Now, mind you, some of them I've only seen once, and some of them it's been a while since I've seen them. And try to ignore the order they're in on the right now. I was trying to kind of put them at like how they were released, but it's not exact. So we're gonna get into this right now. Starting with the original Toy Story. So, like, if you can't tell, I'm doing this on a Word document, and it's super funny, but it works. Toy Story is actually a movie I don't like that much. And some people put Toy Story movies at like super high regard, like they're the best things ever. Toy Story 1, the only issue I have with it is the animation being so old kind of does get to me. Like the people look really creepy. Sid is like super creepy. And like, I don't know, just like the whole story, I don't think is nearly as good as the other Toy Story movies. I'm gonna put it in B. Wow, I can make that a little bit bigger, huh? While I'm here, I'm gonna go ahead and describe. S stands for super, and then all of the ones after that are just less bad, or more bad. So, S is the best. A, B, C, D. It's kind of obvious. I don't think I need to explain it. A Bug's Life is a really good movie. Everybody kind of compares A Bug's Life to Ants. And I'd probably say I'm more of an ants guy. But I would say A Bug's Life also goes into B. I'd say Bug's Life is just, it's a solid movie all around. Not a whole lot to say about it. It's a super cool concept. It really shows like all of the cool stuff they can do with the animation back then, with all of the moving parts. I think it was the second Pixar movie. But again, the story in A Bug's Life is just not really feeling it a whole lot with the whole grasshoppers and like all that weird stuff. Like the weird, I know a lot of people think the caterpillar guy's really funny, but watching it now, he's really not that funny, I'll be honest. Destroy me if you will. Monsters, Inc. I'm gonna go ahead, I'm gonna put it in A tier. Monsters, Inc. is a very good movie, guys. Very good movie. The whole concept of like monsters in your closet and the whole world that they build, even though honestly they could do a little bit better at kind of creating the world, they don't explain as much as it would be nice to. It's just really cool. Like, I think the relationship between Mike and Sully is really, really cool, and that's honestly like the best part of the movie. And not to mention, Boo has become one of the most iconic characters ever, and it's just kind of cool, like how like Boo and Sully kind of have like a father-daughter relationship, and he learns to care about her. Being a parent now, that's a pretty cool concept there. And it's something you can really appreciate. Toy Story 2, by far better than Toy Story 1. I'm gonna put that in A tier. Toy Story 2 is just great. Like the story is way better with Toy Story 2. When they go into the toy store and there's like all those other buzzes, and like you see all the other toys, and I really think like Jessie and Bullseye were a really, really great addition, and it gives you more of a kind of a different outlook on what toys are and like how do toys become alive, what's their purpose, because it shows Squeaker and, you know, he's dying because he doesn't get played with. And the whole thing about Jesse and needing to go back into a museum and being locked away in a box. I think it's really cool. Some of the most emotional moments there when it shows like Jesse and how she got lost and all that. And yeah, great movie. Toy Story 2, phenomenal. Cars. A lot of people give Cars a lot of crap. Cars 1, I'll say right now, kind of spoiling the rest. Cars 1 is by far better than the other Cars movies. By far. I'm going to put Cars right here. I'm going to put Cars in B tier because it's an okay movie. It's an okay movie. I'm not going to give it too much crap, you know. Cars is an overall, it's a fun movie. I think this one is a lot better than the others because it's actually about lightning racing and, you know, Doc teaching him how to race better, him overcoming his cockiness and, you know, really getting down to it and doing what he needs to do. And at the end, you know, sacrificing the first place so what's his face from Dinoco can win. So I think the original Cars is great. I think there's a lot of humor in it. I think that the opening scene is really, really cool, and it's a pretty iconic movie at this point, but I think the first Cars movie is by far the best. Now, Finding Nemo was really, I would say, my first Pixar movie. I remember getting it for my, I think I was in like first grade. Finding Nemo, I think, came out in like 2003 or 4 or something. I was born in 97, so I was like maybe 7 years old when Finding Nemo came out. Finding Nemo is one of my favorite movies of all time. Finding Nemo for me goes in S tier. And this is my list, guys, my personal opinion, so if you want to destroy me, you can. But Finding Nemo is just such a beautiful movie. Just the water and how it was animated, and especially how long ago that was. Just how it shows all the different species of fish and how they interact with each other, and just the way it shows the world is just amazing. And now, you know, being a dad of my own now, you know, I have my boy, 3-year-old boy, and actually another boy on the way. You really kind of think about this differently. It's, you know, it's like the father-son relationship. I really enjoy that there. Incredibles, two incredible movies right in a row. So Incredibles, I am also going to put right up here. Oh, look at that. I forgot the Incredibles 2 logo. Okay, hold on. I'm gonna insert my Incredibles 2 logo. Look at this. Look at how embarrassing this is. Okay. There we go. Okay. Super embarrassing, guys. Hold on. Yeah, you guys are finding out all the secrets on how I put this together, because I've watched a lot of these tier list videos and I was wondering, like, how do they, what's the best way to do this? And I honestly was like, I'll just make a Word document. I created this image myself for this right here, created my own image, and then just loaded this in, and I just loaded all these other logos on top of it, and I'm just splicing them in. And then yeah, I'm just on a Word document right now, capturing my screen. Okay, Incredibles 1, I'm putting an S tier because it's such an amazing movie. And again, being a parent now, I look at a lot of these differently now. But I think even before I was a parent, Incredibles would have been number one. Now, after this, I am going to go ahead and reorder them in the tiers, but right now they are not ordered. The whole family aspect in Incredibles is really great. How it's not a movie about superheroes, it's a movie about a family who are superheroes, and the whole you know, doing everything you possibly can for your family, and the, you know, just everything about it is just great. Like, there's a lot of humor. There's a lot of really cool action. Syndrome, by far, probably the best villain, in like any movie ever, hands down. That's why Incredibles is an S tier. Ratatouille, my favorite movie of all time and all of history. S tier again. Now, mind you, all of the Pixar movies are really, really good. So I don't know if I'll even have any D tier, I'll be honest. Ratatouille, I gotta explain this one because it's gonna be all the way on the left. I could probably rearrange these right now, actually. So Ratatouille has the music and the atmosphere. If you can't tell, I really enjoy like really nice animation and visuals. I think, especially in an animated movie, it really means a lot if you can be like starstruck because of how good it looks. The music and the feeling that Ratatouille gives you with being in Paris, and I don't know, there's something very hard to explain about like why it's just so good. Remy doesn't fit in, and he cooks food. It's a rat. It's a movie about a rat who's very cute, who sits on a guy's head and controls him by pulling his hair, and cooks like gourmet food. It's just such an amazing concept, and it's like, I feel like it's like so down to earth. It's not like a crazy end of the world kind of story, anything like that, and it doesn't need to have a huge story like that. They don't travel super far in Finding Nemo. They don't go across the ocean. They don't go into space. It's just a rat who lives in Paris. Well, he lived in France and then he got sent to Paris on the floaty thingy. And he cooks food and he, explores his passion and he does what he wants to do. And I really love that. I think it's, there's a lot of really funny moments too, but I've talked enough about Ratatouille. Okay, Up. Up is a good movie. I feel like Up is kind of hard to watch over and over and over again. And saying that, I'm gonna go ahead and put it in B tier. Up is a good movie, guys, but again, it's just the beginning part of the movie when it shows, his wife dying and everything. That's a super emotional moment, and it's super cool to see how they can tell such a big story in such a small amount of time. But after that, just like there's this bird. There's like talking dogs. Like, I'm all for like super outlandish stories. But with Up, I just feel like the pacing is kind of weird. And, I'm gonna put Up in C tier now that I talk about it. Because it's my list. I don't gotta conform, right, guys? It's hard to watch over and over again. And it's never been one of my favorites. Like, there's a few funny moments, and I'll watch it and I'll enjoy it because all of these movies are good movies, well, except a couple, I'll say. But all of these movies are good movies. But Up, I just don't enjoy it as much as the others. I'll just say it. It's just kind of slow. It's kind of hard to follow. Like, what's kind of the point? It's kind of tough. It's a tough movie for me. It's not a movie if I gotta sit down and be like, hey, you want to watch a Pixar movie? Let's put on Up. That's not never my first option. Inside Out, amazing movie. It's a movie I didn't think I would enjoy as much as I do. I'm gonna put that in A tier. The whole aspect of like, hey, like these are your emotions, and we're in somebody's head, and how the emotions interact inside of Riley's head, and then it shows like how Riley reacts is just. It's such a creative idea. I would love to see an Inside Out 2. I think they could have done a little bit more with it, though, I'll be honest. But I'm hoping an Inside Out 2 like really explores possibly more emotions and like more complex stuff. And I think it's hilarious how it, when it does show other people's emotions, like it showed that one boy in her class and they're like all freaking out because the girl is talking to him. I think those kinds of moments are just really make that movie shine, like pretty hardcore. Inside Out, The Good Dinosaur is a good movie. Probably the most visually stunning movie
of all time, like in all of history and all of animation. The story is lacking pretty hard, though. Now, I would put it. No, I would put. I'm either thinking B or C for The Good Dinosaur. Because it's just. It's not up there. You know, it's definitely not A. Like, it's a decent movie, and you can have fun watching it. If you're a little kid, you're just having fun seeing a dinosaur. But I really wish there was more. There's just like more story to it. It's just the main dude, I forget his name. The main dude gets lost, you know, his dad dies, he's trying to find his way home, and then he meets like this human boy. But like it doesn't really show the other humans, and it doesn't really make the humans and the dinosaurs interact with each other. Like it's just one human and it's one dinosaur, right? But it's never like okay, so maybe the other dinosaurs need to accept the humans, so the humans can become part of their, you know, society. And you know, it's a movie that's trying to make it on a really grand scale, but it fails in the story aspect of that. It does hurt for me to put it down here, but I gotta put it down here in the C tier. Not much will be down here, but The Good Dinosaur is going down there. I hate to say it, but okay, Brave. Brave, I have only seen once. I guess one. Brave, I have only seen once. Only seen this once. Like I said, 3 times already. It's a good movie. It was a little bit different than I thought. A lot of people don't even know it's a Pixar movie because it really just seems like a Disney animation movie. It is a decent movie, you know. It's about Meredith and, you know, turning her mom into a bear. It's really like a mother-daughter movie, which I'm neither, but I'm not putting it up there. I just set it down. It's a decent movie. Again, not great. I don't know, like. Again, it's trying to make it. I'm gonna put this in C down here with these guys. It's trying to be this like grand scale kind of movie, like this huge adventure, right? And that's like what it was advertised as. But it's really not that big of an adventure. It's like they stay in this tiny little area and it's like, oh, I turned my mom into a bear. I gotta be nicer to my parents, blah, blah, blah. Brave is just not. It's not really my cup of tea. It's definitely not my favorite. There's a lot of other Disney princess movies better, like Tangled. Brave is just not my favorite. I don't have a lot to say about it. Toy Story 3, phenomenal movie, guys. Phenomenal with the PH. I'm gonna put Toy Story 3 right up here. S tier. Toy Story 3 is amazing. I told you there'd be a lot of high-ranked movies. It's Pixar, guys. Toy Story 3. It took everything good about the first two Toy Story movies and made it even better. I love Barbie and Ken were super funny, and you know, again, it's like it's an adventure that feels very grand in this small world. And it's just really cool that they explore, hey, toys live in different places. Like, not every toy just lives in a kid's house. And I think it's really cool that it explores that, you know, and the emotional payoff, you know, Andy got old, he didn't play with the toys anymore, and you know, just the fact that at the end, you know, he gives the toys to Bonnie, I think that always makes me want to cry, you know, just because we've watched them in the last two movies. Andy was such a big part of the story, he's grown up now. You know, it's a good movie, guys. It's a good movie. Cars 2 is going to be, I'm gonna spoil it already, the only D tier movie. Only D tier. So, Cars 2, I don't need to talk about this very much because I feel like it's kind of obvious. Cars 2 took everything good about Cars 1 and pretty much did away with it. So, one of the good parts about Cars 1 is it's about cars doing car things. Cars are racing. So like, hey, what's it like to race in, you know, what would it be like in a world of cars? What would be important to the cars in the car world? And to us, how we know cars, cars drive. So cars race. That makes sense, right? It wasn't about, the first Cars wasn't cars, but the cars are playing basketball, right? So in Cars 2, like, there are spies, and it just, it doesn't fit in the universe. A lot of the things that they do is just really weird. I'm like, they have guns and they shoot stuff, and it's about Mater instead of Lightning McQueen. It's really a movie that should have just been a straight-to-TV release, and I don't need to say much more about this. I'm pretty sure everybody has a fairly similar opinion about Cars 2, unless if you're in, like, the first grid. That sounded kind of harsh, guys. Mind you, this is just my personal opinions on all of these, okay? So, okay. So, we are going to Monsters University. You know, I said a lot of these movies were really, really great, and now I'm kind of, I don't want to say I'm going back on it. Monsters University is okay. And I'm going to go ahead and put, I have to put Monsters University in C tier. And I need to put it on C tier because if I try to even compare Monsters University to the original Toy Story, A Bug's Life, or Cars, it does not hold a candle. You know what I mean? Monsters University, again, like with some of these sequels, it took what was fun about the first movie and just kind of did away with it. I personally think I think the idea of a prequel and how they met was really cool, but kind of like what they did in Cars 2, they took the Cars world in Cars 2 and turned it into a human world, but with cars. That's exactly what Monsters University did. It's like, this is a monster world, but it looks so much like ours. And, like, all of the chairs and the buildings and everything, it just looks like the things that normal humans would be in. But they're not. They're monsters. I wanted to see more of the monster world expanded. But this movie kind of took the monster world we saw in Monsters, Inc. and shrunk it down and gave us less to see. Yeah, so was not great. Really, really was not. Okay, so we're going to go to Finding Dory now. Finding Dory. I know you want me to get up to this one, but not quite yet. Finding Dory, I saw in the movie theater when my wife was pregnant, so it's kind of like my son's very first Pixar movie. I really like Finding Dory. It's not as good as Finding Nemo. It has its flaws, for sure. And again, it kind of took the same premise with the other sequels, and it took some of, this one didn't necessarily take what the first movie did right and not do that. This movie kind of just tried to imitate the first movie a little too much out of, like, to see, just something else. Like, it's kind of hard, like, the ocean is so huge. There's a lot you can do. Like, they could have gone to, like, the North Pole or something. Or that maybe they could have dealt with, I don't know, maybe a bad guy, maybe somebody littering, or maybe helped, like, a blue whale find its way somewhere because, they're going extinct or something. I don't know, just something. But Finding Dory was just like, oh, okay. Dory is, you know, she doesn't know who her parents are. She's been living with them for a whole year, and she just now remembers. Nemo is still the same age, even though it's been a whole year, and they're fish, which, you know, he'd be, like, full grown by then, being a clownfish like he is. I don't know, we got to see the turtles again, and the turtles did the exact same thing they did in the first movie, which was kind of redundant. Finding Dory was good, though. And it's a good watch, you know, it's something I can enjoy. Sorry about that, I had to take a drink of water. And it's something you can enjoy, so I'm going to put Finding Dory in the B tier. Because it's a good movie, it's a good watch. Oh, well. I have no idea why I tried to do that. I tried to move it on my OBS. Finding Dory's gonna be right here in B tier. Not as good as A tier or S tier for sure. Cars 3, I'm gonna make this quick. Cars 3, improved on Cars 2. So it's pretty much like a Cars 1, but not quite as good. I don't even have enough room down here. So, I'm gonna do this. I didn't think I would have this many things in C tier. There we go. Cars 3. Right here. I'm gonna put Cars 3 in C tier because, well, it's not as good as the first Cars, so it has to be below it. I don't think Cars 3 is worthy of B tier. I don't think Cars 3 is as good as Bug's Life or Finding Dory. Finding Dory was just more of a fun adventure. Finding Dory did have some pretty nice emotional payoffs. Cars 3 was okay. It's like, okay, well, he's Lightning McQueen is an old man now. He doesn't look old. How long is this after the other movies? Are we not going to mention Cars 2 at all whatsoever in this movie? I don't know. It's just, I don't know. Cars 3 was okay. It was a good movie. Not the best. Not Pixar's best. So, Incredibles 2, right up here in A tier. Amazing movie. Incredibles 2 took a lot of what made Incredibles 1 good and just, I'm not going to say did it better, because I think the first Incredibles is a little bit better. Just a little bit, mind you. But Incredibles 2 really talked about like them as a family, and the family aspect was a lot stronger in this movie, which made the first movie really, really good. And I think the villain was really good. And overall, it's just a great movie. There's a lot of humor. Incredibles 2 is probably like the funniest Pixar movie there is. There's so much humor in it. The whole thing with Violet and her boyfriend and all of that. Now, Dash was kind of like not present in this movie, and that was kind of sad. I wish Dash had more of a story. But I think maybe they might have focused on Dash a little bit more than they did in Violet in the first movie. And then Jack-Jack was really funny as well. So Incredibles 2 was great, and the first Pixar movie my son ever saw in the theater. So that's pretty cool as well. Now, Coco, amazing movie. Amazing. The best, I'm going to put this right up here in S. Coco has the best soundtrack by far out of any movie. The whole music aspect, the whole movie is about music, so it's nice that it has the best soundtrack. But Coco is just, it's so emotional. And again, it's like the family aspect. Like a lot of these movies have like a really strong family bond. But the whole, you know, like he wants to do what he wants to do. And in the end, he's willing to sacrifice what he loves for his family because he realizes, you know, the importance of it. And, you know, when his nanny dies or his, you know, great-grandma dies and, you know, she's able to visit them from the land of the dead, and the emotional payoff on Coco is, like, superior to all the other movies. Like, Coco just hits you in the feels, you know? It's a great movie. Visually stunning as well. It's great. Like, the story, there's twists and turns. It's a very grand adventure. And Coco's just a great movie. No complaints about it. Toy Story 4 is the most recent movie on this list. My son and I saw this in the theater as well. And I have seen it at home and rented it since. So I've seen it twice. Great movie. I'm going to put... This is going to be an A tier movie. And it's not because I ran out of room on S. Now... It is very, very, very close to S tier. Toy Story 4 is a great movie, and it could have just been called Woody. It's actually the reason my wife doesn't like the movie. The fact that Woody leaves is kind of out of his character. But in my opinion, I think that the whole movie was leading up to that, and Woody just loved Andy so much. And his purpose was kind of just fulfilled, you know? And, but yes, I can take, you know what? I might need to put this in S tier. Yeah, I think I need to put this in S tier. It's gonna be up here. Right up here. I ran out of room on the thingy, guys. Yeah, Toy Story 4 is gonna be S tier. Toy Story 4 is just, I can't, you know, when I'm talking about it and I can't think of anything bad to say. I don't know. This is a tough one, guys. This is a tough one. I think it's gonna go in A tier because A tier, S tier is like above perfect, right? A tier is perfect movies. B tier are very good movies, and C tier are just average. So even C, none of these are bad. D are the only bad movies. Toy Story 4 is just a great movie. The whole what's her name? The doll that's in the antique shop. Her story is great. I absolutely love Bo Peep. I think she's super cool. So I'm gonna go ahead and rank these in the ranks now. Ratatouille is gonna be there. I think this is actually a really good order right here in S tier. Now up here, I'm gonna put Toy Story 4 up here. Toy Story 2 is gonna be at the back end. I'm gonna put Incredibles 2 is just so good. Incredibles 2 is so good. And then I'm gonna put Monsters, Inc. in the middle of those two. And B tier, Toy Story is just not my fave. It's just not my fave. I think in B tier, you guys are gonna hate me, but I think Finding Dory in the B tier is the best. I'd say Cars then. Cars is pretty good. Hey, do you wanna watch Bug's Life or Cars? I'd probably say Cars because it's Cars 1. Cars 1 is great. Down here, this one is a little bit tougher. I definitely say Up belongs there. Brave is a fun movie still. Brave is a fun movie still, but I think The Good Dinosaur might be a little bit better. I honestly think this order is pretty good the way it is. I'm gonna put Brave, Monsters University, and then Cars 3. Yeah, just Cars 3, it's hard for me to say anything good about it. Like, I went through it already. And then Cars 2, obviously. There it goes. Anyways, that's it, guys. That might have been really long, but thank you for listening to me. My final list from top to bottom: Ratatouille, Incredibles, Finding Nemo, Toy Story 3, Coco, Toy Story 4, Incredibles 2, Monsters, Inc., Inside Out, Toy Story 2, Finding Nemo, Cars 1, Bug's Life, Toy Story, Up, Good Dinosaur, Brave, Monsters University, Cars 3, and Cars 2. That's my list, guys. Thank you for listening. I might do more of these videos. If you want to see them, let me know. All right. And I'll see you in the next one. Yeah, make sure to leave a comment and, like, tell me why I'm stupid in the comment section below. Thank you.